We are 5 foot 6, we are 6 foot 1, we are changing, we are strong and brave, we are powerful and confident, we are introverts, extroverts, we are right, we are wrong, we have something to say, we don't all have the chance to say it, so this is our chance, our moment, so
deficit, knock off the debt bit by bit, just ignore food banks increasing, look at all the fab homes releasing.
My foreign policy of peace, protecting them that overseas, we look out for the common mass, serving each one class by class.
And as your head spins round and round, we have meetings underground, we hear every little sound, counting carefully every pound.
We have such different philosophies,
it's not an illusion of choice. We happen to sing in tandem, but we have difference in voice. Thatcher is our god, and Blair is our martyr. Private sector spreading, NHS a starter. So every vote you give to us supports my campaign battle bus. Join us on our journey here, don't think too much, don't be queer.
I believe my opponent here just made a homophobic comment.
Sorry, I just want to say that everything my opponent's been saying in the news recently is fake. It's fake news.
Disagree.
Launch personal attack. Deploy personal attack.
Comment on,
comment on appearance.
Comment
launch personal attack.
Comment on.
I'm center right.
I'm center left.
I'm center this.
I'm center that.
And together.
We'll fuck it all up.
Well, I would abolish tuition fees, put more money into state schools and gradually fade out private education, increase paid paternity leave and make it more accessible so then mothers and fathers can take leave without it impacting their careers, rejoin the EU if possible, allowing free trade and free movement because I'm not racist. Allowing refugees and make sure they are respectfully treated when they arrive, No one deserves to be sent to a detention centre because they're not British. Remove all funding from our nuclear weapons and put more money into the police force and keeping our streets safe, because that is how you protect the public, not by bombing other countries. Build more social housing and make houses more affordable, otherwise our whole generation will be renting. Increase the cost of the Daily Mail, the Times and the Sun, and decrease the cost of the Guardian and the Eye.
Make sure backpacks, coats and other jackets are left outside of the exam hall. Please ensure all labels are taken off water bottles and your phones and other smart devices such as watches are handed in. Your sleeves must not be covering your arms. Remember, no communication between any candidate is allowed. You are not allowed to ask the invigilator any questions. When and if you collect a pen, you'll be given an exam paper and can start your exam. Those who fail to reach a pen will not take an exam. It won't progress any further. Good luck!
If you attended public school, please step forward 3 spaces. If you do not suffer from learning difficulties such as dyslexia or dyspraxia, please step forward 1 space. If your school had a well-equipped library, please step forward 1 space. If English is your first language, please step forward 2 spaces. If you were in top set maths and English, please step forward 1 space. If you had extra tutoring outside of school, please step forward 1 space. If both your parents studied at university, please step forward 2 spaces.
I know that I'm not clever. At least, I know that I don't feel clever. In school, I'm surrounded by the 9s and the 8s and the 7s, but I'm a 5. With a 5, I can pass, but I can't help but feel unclever when the people around me in my class are several steps ahead of me. I almost feel embarrassed to say that I feel lost when I shouldn't, because I'm left to learn as well as everyone else. My spelling is getting worse, and the teachers are either patronising or they just don't care. One teacher described me as a disaster. I might have improved since then, but I can't help but feel that will always apply to me. People think that the only way that I can become clever is to find out how to do English and science and maths, but there are just so many other ways. In class, I can understand it, I get it, but it comes to the exam, and I just can't write it down, and I can't remember it. So therefore, in the eyes of the system, I am not clever.
If you have collected a pen, you may proceed to the exam.
I know that Pythagoras' theorem is a squared plus b squared equals c squared.
I know there are more stars in the solar system than grains of sand.
I know there are more statue lines than real lines.
I know that if you combine the weights of all the ants in the world, they will weigh more than all the humans.
I know that in America, for every one homeless person, there are four empty houses.
I know that the Earth has two moons.
I know Luxembourg is the capital of Luxembourg.
I know that if you take the empty space out of all the atoms, the Earth could be the size of a sugar cube.
I know that your height is roughly the same as your arm span.
I know that scientists know more about outer space than they do about the ocean.
I know that the richest 1% have more money than the poorest 50%.
I know that roughly 2% of the world's population are ginger.
I know that two of us are ginger.
I know that four of us dye our hair.
I know that one of us likes wearing funky hats.
Three of us own sparkly mesh t-shirts.
Well, one of us likes wearing the same fleece over and over and over.
Four of us hate gloves.
Six of us own blue shirts.
Two of us think the blue is a male colour.
The rest of us think your gender shouldn't define what colours you wear.
Three of us have one transgender friend.
One of us has three transgender friends.
None of us are homophobic.
All of us are feminists.
One of us isn't a feminist.
Well, one of us says they're not a feminist, but actually he is a feminist.
The majority of us think this conversation should take place elsewhere.
I know one of us thinks this conversation should continue.
Two of us actually think this conversation should continue.
Because I think deciding if you're feminist or not is the perfect example of freedom of expression, which is so important in today's society.
Yeah, but you say you believe in equality between the sexes, yet you're not a feminist. That doesn't make sense.
I don't think feminism and equality are synonymous anymore.
What about them isn't the same?
I think there's a level of hypocrisy of feminism. They don't protest men's issues, and they don't complain about the benefits women have.
No, but they do talk about men's issues. For example, male suicide rates. They do talk about those things. And although they don't criticise women's benefits as such, they talk about what society has to do to make it more equal for everyone. For example, making paid paternity leave.
Well, yeah, but male suicide and paid paternity leave aren't the only issues men have in life.
Okay, what other issues?
Well, how about that the majority of homeless people and that the majority of workplace accidents? And I think that's because society has pressured men into choosing more dangerous jobs, leaving safer jobs for women.
No, but that happens both ways. Women are pressured not to do those jobs, for example, construction, because it's like, oh, a woman isn't strong enough to do construction, so they can't get jobs in that. It's not that it only
happens. So if feminism actually protested the sexism in the construction industry,
for
example, solving men and women's issues, then I would be a feminist. But for now, me and the majority of women aren't feminists.
No, but it does talk about those issues. And the thing is, the reason so many women aren't feminists is because it's got a bad name and they don't realise that it is.
But
about
if feminism has such a bad name, then why not abandon that movement and go towards other movements?
Because we still need
such
it.
As egalitarian.
But
why do you still need feminism?
Look at our society today. There's still so many reasons why women are treated.
But what can feminism do and not other equality movements not do?
No, because you can't just abandon the movement, because that's like saying you don't need it or it's worthless. Feminism is so needed at this point. For example, the glass ceiling. You have 45% of academical staff in universities are women, but only 22% of professors.
Okay,
are
statistically,
women.
The glass ceiling does not exist.
It does.
Women are not being paid less than a man for
that's
the same
not
job,
what the glass ceiling
and
is.
They're
the
not.
Glass ceiling
women
is
are
not
being.
Promoted.
Yeah, they're not being promoted. That makes no sense, the fact that they're being promoted because they're women. That's ridiculous.
No, they're not getting promoted because they're women. They're not getting promoted because people think they're going to go on maternity leave, or they are going on maternity leave. It's women between
yeah,
a certain age
group. So many other factors to include.
A certain age group, and they think, oh, they're going to go on maternity leave, and we don't want to give them higher paid jobs because then we're going to have to pay them for how
but
many
like
jobs
I, like I said,
off.
There are more factors to include than
yeah.
just maternity.
Yes, there are other factors, but the thing is, there is so many. That's 23%.
Yeah,
yes,
so that
that's
shows
over
that
half.
Not
between this age group, that is because of maternity leave, and that's wrong because that shouldn't be impacting their careers like
but
that.
But the fact that, what does it say a business wants to hire a woman knowing that she's going to be out for the 9 months? Would she want to hire? Would the business want to hire?
No,
no.
That's not the point.
The point is, the point is there are more issues to talk about than just maternity leave when it comes to women in the workplace.
Of course, there are more issues. But the thing is, that's such an obvious one that people still don't seem to care about. Still, people are letting this happen, and it's so not okay.
Yeah, but the fact that people are letting this happen is because it's not sexist. You're just
yes,
assuming,
it is.
Oh, a woman should use emotion, therefore, it's sexist. No.
No.
Oh!
So this was about a year or so ago. We were outside the Mother's Ruin pub in town. It was quite late, or early, I suppose. There were three of us. It was me, Monica, who's a short, half-Swedish, blonde-haired movement woman, and Dickie, who's a big writer man. We were all in the theatre company at the time. So we had a few drinks, and I was feeling quite merry, but those two were properly drunk. And there was this other guy as well, who we didn't know. He was quite drunk as well, and on his own, which is always odd. But you know, we were chatting to him. I think he was like especially trying to chat up Monica, but she was being polite and engaging. She told him that we work in the theatre, and he was like, oh great, I love theatre. I love Shakespeare. She was like, oh yeah, really? Do you know any? And he was like, oh yeah, yeah, tons, I know loads of Shakespeare. And me and Dickie were sat next to them, and we were listening in. And Dickie's quite protective of Monica, in like a brotherly way. And so he heard this guy and he was quite skeptical of his claims. So he turned around and said to him, well, go on then, say something. And the guy, he kind of froze up, didn't know what to say. So Dickie goes again, well, go on then, say something. He goes to Shakespeare and fucking say something, otherwise it's clear you're chatting shit. The guy, you know, he starts getting flustered, emasculated, I think. You know, it's quite stressful for him, so they start swearing at each other. It's getting quite heated. I'm like, Dickie, come on, this isn't worth it. Let's just go with Shakespeare. Come on. So we get up to leave, and this guy is literally watching his chances of getting lucky, he thinks, walking away from him, and that makes him feel quite upset. So he gets up and comes after us, and he shoves Dickie from behind, and Dickie hits the ground, really quite hard, actually. And so I just grab this guy, drag him to the ground, and go, hey, don't you fucking do that! Which wasn't hard, because he was quite drunk, like I said. But that's not the point. The point is, it felt nice to be aggressive and masculine, but also to be doing what I thought was the right thing, which being aggressive and masculine normally isn't.
Well, by far the worst thing we do to males, by making them feel that they have to be hard, is that we leave them with very fragile egos. The more hard man a man feels compelled to be, the weaker his ego. We teach girls to shrink themselves, to make themselves smaller. We say to girls, you can have a bit of shun, but not too much. You should aim to be successful, but not too successful. Otherwise, you would threaten the man. Why should a woman's success be a threat to a man? Why should a woman's success be a threat to a man? And I don't think there's an English word I dislike more than emasculation.
If there is one message that echoes forth from this conference, let it be that human rights are women's rights and women's rights are human rights. Human rights are women's rights and women's rights are human rights, once and for all.
This is no simple reform. It really is a revolution. We are talking about a society in which there will be no roles other than those chosen or those earned. We are really talking about humanism.
I hope that you choose not to be a lady. I hope you will find some way to break the rules and make a little trouble out there. And I hope you'll choose to make some of that trouble on behalf of women.
Nice flag.
flower, isn't it, Mum?
Oh no, the stalk's way too small. What can you do with a tiny stalk?
Okay, what about this one?
Oh, definitely not. That flower is way too ugly. It says on page 3 of the Sun, e-garden guide, that all flowers must be toned with no petals and no thorns.
But the thorns are to protect it. Without the thorns, is it even a rose anymore?
Oh, stop being so philosophical and put them in the vase.
Select character. Aladdin.
Hey.
Jed Hipster.
No.
Gaming.
Yeah, no.
Ed Sheerman.
Yeah.
Ted.
Hi.
And Hugh Dick. Round one. Drink as many pints as you can in 3, 2, 1.
Come on.
Electricity or internet. You can install it yourself, but that'll have to come out of your own pocket.
Any ventilation, natural light.
Okay, so You see the crack in the brickwork? There. That's where you get all your natural light from, not to mention the fantastic view of the local car park.
Oh, yeah. It's good.
That's really nice.
Oh, that's lovely.
Such a huge selling point. Do you mind if we have a little chat?
Okay, I'll give you some space.
Yeah. I think we should go for it. You know, it's the best place we've seen so far.
I completely agree. I'm sick and tired of sharing my family. It was my 35th birthday last week and I thought, finally, I'm old enough to move out if I want to.
You know, I've been saving since I was 11, you know, so many years ago. And, you know, I think I've now just saved enough money to rent somewhere for like a couple months.
Shall we do it?
I think we should do it.
Have you made your decision yet?
Yeah, we'd love to rent it.
Lovely, okay, so should we run through the figures and money? So here's the money and the figures, and upward fees, downward fees, dilapidation fees, and upward across fees, and there we go. So if you guys want to shine it, lovely, and you too. Perfect. So let me just get your key, and the plate is yours.
You felt it. As soon as you were on that street, you felt it. We were the only renters on the street, and that gave them license to watch us through their pristine net curtains. We were blamed for a lot of stuff, like when the drains got blocked on our whole street. They blamed us. We got passive-aggressive little notes through the door. And my mum called a plumber, the only person to actually call a plumber, who said it couldn't be us because it had been caused by a build-up of flushable wipes. Everybody should know flushable wipes are not flushable. And when the landlord came round and stood in our kitchen, his kitchen, underneath a patch of ceiling that had fallen down in the first week and said, "This place had been immaculate." Well, we decided that was enough. So in April, we moved to Porter's Head. Now I have to get up at 5 every morning just to get to my exams on time. Deal with intermittent internet and wait around for buses that never seem to arrive. But it was all worth it. To wind down the window of that removal truck and shout, "Fuck you, you cozy, comfy cunts!" Which probably, in fairness, did reinforce the stereotype of renters.
We don't believe.
Et j'habitais encore en France lors des résultats du Brexit. Depuis, j'ai déménagé ici, en Angleterre. Ce que j'ai remarqué, c'est qu'on a l'impression qu'à part le gouvernement, tout le monde voulait rester. Tout le monde dit « Oh no, gosh, I voted to remain, of course !» Je vous avoue que je comprends toujours pas comment vous avez pu être aussi bête. Et aujourd'hui, si on me demande si je me sens plus anglaise ou française, je répondrai sans hésiter française, et même européenne, les gars. J'ai remarqué aussi que le système des classes sociales, il est super important dans vos vies. Genre, Si vous faites vos courses dans le bon supermarché, Waitrose, Sainsbury's, là ça va, hein, vous êtes des gens bien, des gens respectés. Par contre, si je vous dis Lidl, Asda, direct, vos têtes échangent. Vous imaginez des marginaux. Ne mentez pas, je le vois dans vos regards. Il y a tous ces non-dits, toutes ces règles ridicules, style tu te sers de la mauvaise fourchette pour manger ton repas principal et ils osent même plus te regarder dans les yeux. Ce qui est génial chez les Français, c'est qu'on fait tous la gueule tout le temps, donc personne ne le prend mal. Ah puis on est mal poli, tellement mal poli, c'est fou. Ici, si tu ne souris pas et si tu ne t'excuses pas auprès de chaque passant, bah t'es même pas anglais en fait. Vous savez comment ils sont. Sorry, I'm so sorry, so sorry, 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 I'm so sorry. Non, franchement, l'Angleterre c'est cool, c'est un pays de malade. Les touristes y viennent, ils parlent déjà ta langue. On a toute la nourriture du monde à chaque coin de rue. On a indien, grec, italien, espagnol, français. Nulle part quand tu vas en vacances, tu vas voir resto anglais. Mais bon, vous n'êtes plus européen, vous. Mais tranquille, votre premier ministre a les potes avec les US, ils vont sûrement vous faire devenir le 51e État.
A little over 6 months ago, the British people voted for change. They voted to shape a brighter future.
Perhaps the future, though, I'm sorry, but actually how it's coming is better than what we have right now. A brighter future where we seem to have stopped striving forward as a nation and instead cling onto
for
a
our country. They voted to leave the European Union and embrace the world.
How can you embrace the world when you're shutting yourself off from your nearest neighbours? This is no longer the British Empire. We don't have the might to do this alone anymore. We all need to work together. Individual governments, nations facing...
And they did so with their eyes open.
Eyes open? How can you say it with eyes open when they're with eyes flat and unbuttoned? How can you say it with your own voice when nobody knew what this meant? Not one of you has or even had a plan. That's not eyes open, that is blind faith.
Accepting that the road ahead will be uncertain at times, but believing that it leads towards a brighter future for their children and their grandchildren.
Your children and your grandchildren, who you have sacrificed, are just chances this same opportunity that you all have. You had the freedom of travel, you had the chance to live and work abroad, you could discover the culture. If you actually cared about what your children and your grandchildren were saying, you would realise that we don't want this!
Take this time, if I may, to dedicate this part to a special someone. I think on behalf of the whole cast, we'd all like to say a massive thank you to Nigel Farage. Nigel, you here, pal? Nigel?
Yeah.
Well, here's hoping this reaches you. That's not Nigel. Too posh. Nige, you might say some things that I bitterly, vehemently hate with every ounce of my body. Your insistence, for example, that you're right to feel uncomfortable at the thought of having Romanian neighbours. All the time where you blamed being late for a meet and greet on immigrants clogging up the M4. You might say these things, Nige. God, do I respect you in spite of them. I respect you because you're the type of man who believes the same thing Wednesday as you did Monday, no matter what happens Tuesday. I respect you because you say what you think, no matter how stupid or wrong, so woefully, woefully wrong it is. I respect you because you represent everything that's great about this country. You can say these things because the alternative, Nige, is that you can't say them and they bubble under the surface. You are given a platform to push your agenda and say your mind, and gosh, Mr. Farage, it makes me bloody proud.
Well, you're not really doing it, are you?
I've had my years of polishing. Now it's your turn.
Can I use as protect and guardian on the silver?
Guardian? Protect and guardian? How dare you? That's dirty, tacky, dirty stuff!
Okay, I will just use this Murdo Clean.
Murdo Clean Polish. Established in 1870. Only £10.95 at Groupon Store!
Yes, of course you can use that one.
Are you sure the silver's real? I think it's coming off.
No. It's quite real. Carry on.
No, Mum, I think they're fake. There's not even any hallmark.
Well, Rupert sold them to me, and he's always been very reliable before, so...
Oh, Mum, why did you believe him? I bet you he sold you these polishes too.
How did you know?
Are you an idiot? He practically owns the polish industry. Heck! He is the polish industry!
Shut up and sit down, Sandy! You're making us look like...
Don't let Jeremy put Britain in the core bin!
Never mind Brexit. Who won Lexit?
Court jester.
May heads for election landslide.
Corpse snubs the Queen.
Escaping the May trick.
Off with his warhead.
Battle of the Iron Ladies.
Labour should dump Vampire Corbyn.
And May in June.
Red and Berry.
May Day.
Bit of a boob. Corbyn slaps Thornbury's breast.
The lady is for you, Turnip.
Corbyn urges supporters to vote for Marcel to win Love Island.
May is right for your mess.
Jeremy Corbyn attacks zero-hour contracts at Glastonbury.
May hung out to dry.
Teenage Corbyn squashed my sister's baby rabbit with his pogo stick.
Queen of denial.
Jeremy Corbyn, sex dwarf eaten by otters.
The Iron Maiden.
Jez's jihadi comrade.
Jeremy Corbyn sucks off Boris Johnson at boozy party.
Hello and welcome to How Gay Can You Be? Let's meet this week's contestants.
Hi, I'm Jessie and I'm a French lesbian.
Hi, I'm Dale and I'm a gay from Western Superman!
Hi, I'm Becky and I'm a bisexual from Bristol.
Okay, let's get our game on with question numero uno. When was the first gay pride festival in the UK?
In London in 1972.
That is the correct answer! Question number two. What is your gayest moment?
At the time a guy asked for my number and I wrote lesbian in his phone so he'd leave me alone.
Brilliant! Question number three. What percentage of the British population still thinks that homosexuality is wrong? Amazing! Question number four. Can you please name a gay Harry Potter character?
Voldemort?
Oh, I'm sorry, that's the wrong answer. The correct answer was Dumbledore. Question number five. Can you tell us what gay conversion therapy is?
It is the beating, torturing, chemical castration, chemically induced vomiting, sensory deprivation and use of electric shocks to try and cure gay people.
That is the correct answer, and for a bonus rainbow point, when was it made illegal?
Trick question, it's actually still illegal.
Hooray! Question number four. How many characters are there in the expanded LGBT+ acronym?
13.
That is the correct answer, and for a bonus rainbow point, can you tell us what they are?
Lesbian, gay, bisexual, transsexual. Transgender, queer, questioning, intersex, asexual ally, two-spirited, And pansexual?
Woohoo! That's the right answer! And question number four. What nation has the most LGBT plus members of parliament?
The UK!
That is the correct answer. And for the final question, what's your most awkward gay moment?
Probably right now because my mum's in the audience and she doesn't know that I'm bisexual. Hi, Mum.
Just remember what you get.
She'll have some special guests, I bet. Dan.
Street.
Dan.
Street.
Dan.
Stairs.
Dan.
Stairs.
Dan.
Parcel.
Dan.
Wires.
Dan.
Charge.
Dan.
Detonate. Rumble, rumble, what's that sound?
Flashing lights and children down.
Rumble, rumble, building down.
Parents screaming.
Rumble, rumble, silence.
Scream.
Silence.
Cry.
Silence.
Run.
Silence.
TV. Channel. News. Camera. Nation.
Weeping.
Children.
Sleeping.
Fear. Creeping.
People.
Seething.
Heart.
Breaking.
Hands.
Shaking.
Headlines.
Changing.
Muslim.
Blaming.
Islam.
Hating.
ISIS.
Framing.
Racist.
Trading.
Hateful.
Statement.
Find them.
Wait, what?
Seek them.
What? No.
Catch them.
Please just
burn them.
Please no.
It was a family thing. Me, my brother, my parents, my aunts, uncles, and my two older cousins, we were all raised as Muslims. I remember that I was part of a conversation where my cousins were talking about the outrage about how homosexuality is now a part of education. They said that if they had children who came out as gay, they wouldn't want them as their child anymore. For them, it was absolutely wrong. For some Muslims, they find it very difficult to accept homosexuality within their own families. I wanted to talk, believe me, I wanted to. But instead, I sat there in silence, feeling frustrated and disgusted by what I heard. If I did speak, I wouldn't get any rallying support. No one would change their view. I'll be questioned and judged, and things would just stay the same. This is one of the difficulties that I face, being a liberal in a Muslim family. And yet, when I step outside of the community, when I look at the media, I don't see acceptance or support. I see vindication and hatred. Muslim extremists, Islamists, Islamic fundamentalists. The fear that I face is the possibility of being attacked, walking down the street, walking past the pub, the drunk people thinking, oh, he looks like a Muslim, I wonder if he's got a bomb. The media stoking up hatred and bigotry after 24-hour roll-around coverage of a terrorist attack. Muslim extremists, Islamists. Being a Muslim means different things to different people, and yet it is to be restricted to being a stereotype, or being put in a box by the media, the public, my family. These labels do not define me or anyone else. I am not a terrorist. I am not a homophobe. We are not all the same. Do not treat us the same. Do not put your ideas on me. You don't know me. I am my own person.
Would you like a present?
Yes, please.
There it is.
Wow, the NHS! Thank you.
Have you got in there then?
Wow, look at all these nurses!
How many have you got there, Sandy?
Yeah, about 30.
Oh, you don't need that many, Sandy. There you go.
Oh no, please don't limit my staff.
Anything else in there, Sandy?
Wow, look at all these hospital beds!
How many have you got there, Sandy?
About 25.
Oh, one more for good luck.
There you go. Now I'm left with the Royal Foundations of the hospital.
Oh, so sad.
Never mind. I will just spend my own money.
Where did you get that from, Sandy?
Auntie Betty sent it to me in the post last week.
But you've been claiming all week that you haven't had any money. In fact, I had to give you some. So that's mine with interest. Would you like another present, Sandy?
I vote yes!
I haven't got you one.
But you just promised.
Promises.
The healthcare assistant will be with you shortly. We hope you enjoy your stay.
So thank you, NHS. I'm really grateful.
Yes.
at one. Some of us a little bit sweatier than others, but all that little bit older. We hope you can understand why this was difficult. There is so much to talk about, so much to agree and disagree on, but that's exciting, and it's exciting that we can have these conversations. We're really grateful that you came all the way out here to listen, especially as we are basically in Cajun. If you loved it, that's amazing. If you hated it, it's fine, we get it. We shouldn't have lied about the promise of brafts. But there you go, that's it, this is us.